So guys, for today's video, I want to share with you on how to make an enrollment system using PHP. So, bago tayo dumako sa pinaka-web page natin, i-discuss ko muna kung ano nga ba yung enrollment system. The enrollment system project manages the record of the enrolled student of Siloam Christian Academy. The system can only be managed by the admin user, which means student and faculties do not have any access to this record. The system admin will create the academic year to organize the enrollment records by setting the academic year as default to the system. All enrolled student record that can be found will be based on the default academic year. This system is easy to modify to create more features such as creating a tracking record view for the record of the student per academic year. So, yung features ng ating system ay dashboard page, academic year, level and section, faculty page, student list, and yung system about. So, dito sa dashboard page, this is the welcome page of the admin after login to the system. On this page, the total number of enrolled students and faculties are displayed as the summary of the system record. Sa academic year naman, this page is located under academic navigation. This is where the academic year of school year is listed and being managed. Next is level and section. This page is located under academic navigation. This is where you can create, edit, and delete grade, level, and section. Next one is faculty page. On this page, the list of advisor are displayed and their handle grades, level, and section. This is where an admin sets an advisor for the class. Next one is student list. This is the page where enrolled students are listed, filtered by the default academic year. Also, in this page, the admin can enroll students. And the last one is system settings. This is the page where the admin will be set the school details. On this page, the admin can dynamically change the system info, just as school name, address, and logo. So next is, I will discuss the web page. So this is the design of the web page. The title of the web page is Siloam Christian Academy Enrollment System. So may login form ka. May login form dito bago ka makapunta sa pinaka homepage. So, magda-login muna tayo. Click login. So, after mag-login, pupunta ka sa pinaka homepage ng system, which is yung nakalagay dito sa pinaka sidebar is yung dashboard, student list, faculty, academic, and about. Sa academic, may dalawang category. Yung una is year, and level and section. So dito sa dashboard, makikita kung ilang student ang naka-enroll sa school and ilang faculty member ang naka-assign dito. Then sa student list naman, then dito makikita yung mga enrolled student name ng student, level and section, advisor kung sino yung advisor na humahawak sa kanila, and student type. Dito sa student type, meron tayong new, regular, return, yung mga bumalik na student, and transferee. Then sa action. Dito sa action, pwede ka mag-edit ng pangalan nila or mga info ng isang estudyante and mag-delete ng student kung hindi naman na sila enroll. ng taon na to. Dito sa faculty, dito nakapaloob po yung mga advisor. Name, advisory, kung may advisory class ba sila na hinahandle, and action din. So, sa academic, sa year, so, naka-default tayo sa taong 2021 sa 2022. So, bali, lahat ng record ng taong ito ay yun lang yung makikita nyo. Relevant section. So, bali, high school tong enrollment system na to, kaya meron tayong 4. Grade 7, 8, 9, and 10. Then, yung section ng grade 7, Ezra, grade 8, Jeremiah, grade 9, Luke, and grade 10 is Genesis. So, sa about naman, dito nakasulat yung school ng name of school, school address, and school logo. So, anytime pwede itong palitan ng admin. Kung magpapalit man sila ng pangalan, school address, and logo. So, dito, sa student list, pwede ka mag-add ng student. So, click mo lang yung enroll new student. So, lalagay tayo ng new. Magta-type tayo ng pangalan ng student. So, kung anong taon ba sila mag-e-enroll? Or anong year pala? Anong year? Then, save. Then makikita nyo dito is na-add na siya dito sa mga student. Then sa faculty naman tayo, pwede ka rin mag-add ng faculty. So, advisory. So, dahil nga meron ng lahat ng advisory class, NA na to. So, bali, normal na teacher lang siya, all faculty member. Then, coding na tayo. Yung una natin i-code is yung pinaka login system or yung pinaka web page natin. So copy lang na rin ito para mas madali. So, tapos na tayo sa login page. So, lalagyan pa na natin yung style yung ating CSS. Then, okay na tayo sa login form. So, next na i-code natin is yung pinaka-homepage. No, next is the student, please.
Julia, sabe, sai no meu trabalho.
Max X enrollment. is faculty. Then see. So next is level and section. See. Then school year. Then soon. And the last one is site settings or the about.